If you're still using physical SIM cards and often cry when you realize you have lost this, well, watch on, because nowadays, people are using eSIM, and while those are dangerous, it is not. Here's what you really should know. So, you might have read some scary stories in the last few years about eSIM.
What's he doing?
He's just standing there, menacingly!
In 2023, a Circles.Life customer's mobile line was taken over by a hacker after she revealed sensitive details to an impersonator. In 2024, it's reported that StarHub was being investigated after hackers took control of at least one customer's phone line. Now, this seems scary. Almost like hackers can hack into our phones because we use eSIMs instead of the traditional SIM cards. Well, here's the thing, that could happen even when you're using a traditional SIM card too. But firstly, you need to know what eSIMs are.
What's he doing?
He's just standing there, menacingly!
To know what eSIMs are, you need to know what the traditional SIM cards are. You see, this SIM card is nothing more than just an ID. For example, there are two cards here. The key data that is registered in the first SIM card is this. The card's ID is 1234567. And similarly, the key data that is registered within the second SIM card is this. This card's ID is 98765432. Yeah, that's all. In fact, SIM stands for Subscriber Identity Module, which, well, you know, it's just about identifying who you are. It's a card because in the past, this is how a SIM card looked like. So, what happened is that the telco will just, tell the SIM card what the number is when they register you so as to identify you. Now you know why this is so obsolete, because it's just, telling the card who you are. So why not just download the data into a pre-made card inside a phone? Yeah, that's what eSIM is. Because here's the thing, eSIM doesn't stand for electronic SIM, but embedded SIM. This means for phones that support eSIMs, which are most modern phones, there is an embedded SIM card that you cannot remove, kind of like our phone batteries. Anyways, technically it's a chip, but anyways. eSIM basically means telco can, tell the eSIM who you are, therefore registering you. The good thing is that unlike physical SIM card that can hold only one ID, an eSIM can hold multiple IDs, so you can store a few nines in the eSIM, although it can usually only run one or two nines at once. Now, you can see how convenient it is. You will not need to wait for days for your SIM card to arrive, only to realize that you have lost that goddamn pin used to open the SIM card tray. You can register with an email sent in by your telco or a QR code they provide. Yeah, and this is exactly when the issue happened. Because if the telco didn't check your identity well, your ID might be provided to another person instead.
What's he doing?
He's just standing there, menacingly!
If you're looking to advertise your business in this channel, we can help you. There are guaranteed views and many big brands have trusted us. Just click on the link in the description. Remember the woman who circumcised mobile line was taken over by a hacker? What happened is that an impersonator spoke to her, whereby she revealed sensitive personal details, and the impersonator used the sensitive personal details to register a new eSIM under her name, and therefore took over her account. This can happen to physical SIM cards too. For example, a man managed to steal your NRIC, and with your NRIC, he went to a telco and tell the telco he is the person in the NRIC, and had lost his phone, so he need a new SIM card. With the control of a mobile phone number, he will use it to take over your accounts like your WhatsApp or any app that needs phone number for verification. Similarly, the same thing happened for StarHub last year, though the issue is that StarHub was accused of failing to verify the identity of users. But the idea is the same. Someone claimed it's you and take a new SIM card, whether it's physical or eSIM. Now, you'll know that it's therefore relatively safe. But if it's so convenient, why are people still not using them?
What's he doing?
He's just standing there, menacingly!
Currently, I could not find any public information on how many percent of people in Singapore use eSIM. However, a global survey shows that less than 40% of people know what eSIM are. And it's not a matter of hardware, as most modern phones have eSIM. Therefore, it's mainly about education. However, eSIM is used quite commonly when we travel overseas. You see, back in the old days, when we went overseas, the first stop we headed to is a shop that sold SIM cards for data. Nowadays, we either buy roaming from our telco, or we can opt for an even cheaper option, buying temporary eSIM brands overseas. They are cheaper, and all you need to do is to activate it when you are overseas. Ta-da! You have data immediately. What's next is unknown, but I think it's safe to say that two things will be obsolete in the next 10 years. Physical SIM cards and the other thing out. Thank you for spending almost 4 minutes with me. I really appreciate it and hope you learn something. What's the other thing?